Congratulations on your Grammy nomination. How did it feel to be nominated in the metal category?
I thought it was absolute prank call. When somebody said you got nominated, I'm like, you're lying, get off my line. Then later on they called, would you guys perform? I'm like, are you crazy? This is Body Count. This is the band that they wanted to ban in the country. They wanted to crucify us. And here we are 20-something years later and we're being nominated by something as distinguished as the Grammys. What a difference a day makes. I guess that's all you could say.
And you recently tweeted, you know, like, rock has no color. What does that mean to you?
Well, you know, that's, it doesn't, because it's a state of mind. You know, when we first went out on the first Lollapalooza tour, I would do half a set of Ice-T, and then I would stop and I would start Body Count. And that's what I would say. I say, right now, I'm about to prove to you the rock has no color. It's a state of mind. And we would turn those amps up, and the crowd that just sat through a hip-hop show found themselves headbanging. So I just believe it's whatever sense, whatever you, rock is an attitude, you know? Like when you're pop, you're like, you know, everyone get along, love your mother, do your homework. Rock is, I ain't doing my homework and I ain't going to school. It's rocking, you're rocking the system. So, you know, F that is rock.
Now in 2018, do you think that, you know, like, rock is being represented well?
Not really. Metal isn't. Metallica is in rock, but heavy metal still isn't. So, like, I came from hip-hop who wasn't getting respected. Now I'm in heavy metal, and they're getting less respect than hip-hop. So I got another job.
What are you going to do about it?
Trying to make it more. You know, a lot of people say, well, boycott it. But then what do you prove with that? So we're just going to come, and we're going to try to give a kick-ass performance and let them see why people love the genre so much.
And like you mentioned, you know, like, hip-hop before, it was kind of like misconstrued and a lot of people weren't allowing it in, but now you have you have Kendrick and Jay-Z nominated in Album of the Year. What does that mean for hip-hop today?
That's a great thing. You got the OG Jay-Z, who's put out some of the greatest, you know, rap music in history, and you've got the young buck Kendrick, who is now putting out some of the greatest. So that's a good competition, you know. It's good, man. You know, the thing of it is you want to win the award on merit, not, oh, we got to get more black people or we got to get more women or that. You want to just win it because it's the best record, you know, and to be judged by your peers is very important. It's not a fan thing. It's not about who's the most popular. It's what they think is the best album, how it's made and how it's put together. So it's important to somebody like us.
Amazing. And speaking of merit, right now we're kind of seeing that kind of happen with this, all these women's movements now. What are some lessons for both of y'all think we should take from the current movement?
I can start with you. I mean, as a woman, you kind of just are used to what's going on. You're used to men saying things. You're used to getting a little touch here and there. I mean, when women take it, it's like normal. So I don't know. It's just like, to hear it now, it's like, okay, now women are uniting and standing together and, you know, wanting to speak out. I think it's a cool thing. Very cool
thing.
It's
also, where do you draw the line? It's a lot of things, you know, where one day I could flirt with you and the next day I'm assaulting you. So you got to try to, I think we got to get a more of a better communication to where, you know, it's not okay and what's okay. But I've been on a show, SVU, that deals with, you know, rape and pedophiles, and that's the one thing that's not even accepted in prison is raping and things of that nature. So it's never cool. It's not okay. It's just, you know, one of those things where the dialogue has to start. So, you know, men understand, hey, you know, listen.
Communication and education.
And education, you're right, absolutely.